Welcome back to another Q&A video, guys. I'm your host, Christo from Stud City, and today we have an exciting episode. It's our 10th episode, and of course, it's pretty straightforward. I just answer the questions you guys leave from the comments below. So if you want to ask a question, feel free to ask by using /AskSC, and I'll be sure to answer it in next week's video on Friday. So I have been uploading these every Friday, which has been an absolute blast. So I love answering you guys' questions. Make sure to leave more questions, and I will be sure to answer them. But let's go ahead and answer last week's questions in today's video. So let's go ahead and jump straight on into it. The first question is going to come from Shifty Shredder. He says, ask SC, what do you think about mega constructs with the various like themes like Halo or Call of Duty? Do you think it is a Lego knockoff? Well, of course it is a Lego knockoff, right, Shifty? It is a Lego knockoff. However, I think it's so interesting on the themes they have and like the branded deals that they have, because that's something I've been super drawn to. I'm not a huge Mega Constructs fan. I only have one Mega Constructs set, which is a Pokemon set. I'm a huge Pokemon fan. And I'll show you a little bit more on that in just a little bit. But I love the themes that Mega Constructs has. As a Lego fan, it completely hurts that they have the licensed theme to like Pokemon, even like Halo, since I know there's a ton of fans out there, huge fan base, as well as like new modern day Hot Wheels. Now that they've taken over Hot Wheels, I think it's a strong competitor for the Lego group. But unfortunately, I'm going to completely side with Lego here. The quality of bricks from Mega Constructs for me is just not up to par compared to Lego. Just over time, they've kind of just fall apart. Like my Pikachu's fallen apart multiple times. But anyways, let's not focus on that. Let's just take a look at some of the sets they have. One is going to be, well, we'll start with these Halo set, the Warthog Rally. It looks kind of kiddish in my opinion. I don't really like the figs compared to a minifig. I'm not sure what to call them. They look more of kind of like action figures rather than like minifigs. But interesting, right? I am happy it serves a fan base, right? There's a lot of Halo fans out there, so it's pretty exciting to see. What I'm more drawn to, like I said earlier, was the Pokemon stuff. Like this brick-built Gyarados is freaking moving. This thing's absolutely epic. I know it had a high retail price, I believe of like $250 or $300, but it's often on sale. So like currently right now on Target or Amazon, this thing is $122, which I think is a bang for your buck. It has movability. It's a large set. I've seen it in person and it's massive. So something really, really cool. Then they have like this Pikachu that's moving as well, kind of like similar to the Gyarados, but probably less moving parts. I know all four legs move and he kind of like looks like he's running. They have the Squirtle evolution. So Squirtle, Wartortle, and Blastoise. They have a Pokeball that's relatively cheap. I believe it's like $30 on sale as well, which is interesting. But anyways, yeah, so I'm absolutely in love with Pokemon. I can go on and on about this nonstop. Please just cut me off, guys. Again, I wish Lego would make Pokemon Lego. So unfortunately, they won't and will most likely never. I have one Lego set that I made for Pokemon, but I'll show you that in just a minute. But here's another licensed theme that I think is a strong competitor for the Lego group, the Hot Wheels. They've been producing some really good looking vehicles. I think it's probably their number one aesthetically pleasing sets. Their cars look awesome. So I personally never bought one or built one. I'd imagine the pieces are similar to the Pokemon ones where they're a little bit more fragile and come apart. But as far as aesthetics, they do look really good and quite comparable in price. But I will link a video of my mock Lego Pokemon Center if you're interested in watching that. That was really awesome to put together, and the reason I made that is because the Lego group will never make a Lego building or a Lego Pokemon anything, basically, because Mega Constructs is a competitor. So that's why I made that myself out of Lego. Now that's not to say, you know, who knows, maybe the future holds something different. I don't know, right? I'm not a future fortune teller, right, or anything like that. So hopefully one day, but again, highly doubt it. But anyways, our next question is going to come from Tree Spire. It's going to ask SC, what's the best way to plan out a custom modular building? Awesome question. There's a few different items I'd like to go through. One being, of course, your base plate, right, and what your kind of plans are and like overall shape. 2 is the pieces, and then 3 is to kind of pair it next to another modular to kind of give you an idea. So I'm going to go ahead and flip the camera around and kind of show you what I'm talking about.
So Lego modulars are basically built on these base plates, right? Which is a 32 by 32 base plate. Now, fortunately, the buildings don't take the entire base plate, right? Normally they have, you know, they can have waterway like this Ninjago City modular, or they can have a walkway, which is a lot more common. So you're already gonna be looking at 4 studs already pushed back where maybe the building starts. But in this case, it has stairs going up. So essentially this is around 7 bricks all the way back, the building starts. So that's kind of what I was talking about. The first thing you're going to do is kind of start getting your layout implemented into this.
So what's really interesting is all the different modular setups. So like I said, Ninjago City having a different setup compared to this modular building on the right side. But essentially, you just kind of want to get your layout going with some bricks and kind of just start mapping out your layers.
But you can see what I'm talking about by starting to build the shape of this. So in this case, I would start building a Lego modular that was going to be this nice rectangular shape. I'd have a few studs, maybe around 8 studs in the back that's just kind of left open, where you could start, you know, making like a mock backyard or something, or maybe like a walk down staircase, or maybe a crawl space, similar to some other modulars. And then, of course, the front is going to be our walkway for our Lego civilians. Moving that aside, we also have to think and keep in mind our Lego modulars are going to come in floors. So when you do this design, right, and you start building up your first layer, keep in mind that you want to cap this off so you can start building future layers, right? So when you build the second floor, it could be completely detachable. You could start from scratch, do something similar like this where you have plates all around and then you have your flooring below. So that way it can stick quite nicely to the next adjacent floor and so on. And you could build your way all the way up and get something sort of like this.
The other thing to note here, TreeSpire, is the organization of your pieces is going to be pretty important just because it's going to maximize efficiency and you're going to know where to get your parts and pieces where instead of, you know, a drawer like this where you have no idea where things are, it would be very difficult to build a Lego modular building if you're trying to find a bunch of 1x4 bricks and want to build walls, and instead you're finding flag pieces and Ninjago dragon heads and stuff like that. So I would say organization definitely comes into play here. It just helps substantially when building.
But of course, getting down and dirty and just starting to build your Lego modular is not the only way of doing things. There's probably a more orthodox way of doing this, and you could do this online using apps such as like Lego Designer Program or Studio. However, I just don't really enjoy designing Lego online. It's just a personal opinion. I don't do it. I'd rather just sit here and build with bricks and kind of get to where I'm going and kind of rely on pictures that like I have for inspiration. That's kind of my inspiration for building. There's many ways to get to a one end goal, right? And I know people really enjoy building in studio and then going and building that project. I think that's awesome. I wish I had the patience for that. I just simply don't. So my other suggestion is find something that works for you. If getting down and dirty, opening bins and starting to build is your goal, then do that, right? That'll get things. The only thing I'm gonna probably steer away from recommending is just getting a whole box and shoving all your Lego pieces and just sorting through there and building from it, because that will take forever. But hey, you can still do it, right? But anyways, guys, that's going to be 2 great questions for our episode 10, and that's going to wrap up episode 10. Make sure to ask your questions below in the comments below, and I'll be sure to answer them in next week's video. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you in the next one. As always, peace out, guys. Stud City, out.